Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom Shop here. Okay, some of you have asked advice on how to go about cutting chin cuts to plastic slides. Well, here we go. I'm going to give you a quick tutorial on how to do it. Now, when I say chin cuts, a lot of you might be scratching your heads going, what the hell are they? Well, a chin cut is this. If I just zoom in for you, or focus in, I should say. These are your chin cuts. They're the scalloped cutouts that you get on the forward section of a slide. These ones, which were the early ones that were done to Browning's 1911 design, were called ball cuts because they were more rounded. They weren't so angled like the ones are on the standard 1911, which you can see there. As you can see, they're more rounded. They're more sort of sloped, these ones, the later versions. But the early ones were ball cuts, which are more rounded. So there you go, just a little bit of history lesson for you. Okay, how do you go about doing it? Well, what you want to do is take measurements first. Now, hopefully you can see on there, if I focus in. The dimensions are 15 millimetres in from the angle there, so that's 15 millimeters in from there, and it's 5 millimeters up. So if you want to get an idea as to the depth of these cuts, they are 5 millimeters that way, i.e. up the slide, and they are, well, the 15 millimeters is for the actual rake of the cutout there. The actual rounded cutout there is 15 millimeters along, so it's 5 millimeters up. Now then, on the front edge, i.e. the actual depth of that is, I can tell you now, is 1, 2, 3, 4 millimetres. It is 3 millimetres, 3 and a bit. So the actual depth of those cutouts, i.e. the actual depth in that way, is 3 millimetres. And it's 5 millimetres up that way. So hopefully I've explained myself right there. So you're 5 millimetres that way and 3 millimetres in that way. Alright? And the actual length of the rake of the rear part of the cut is 15 millimetres. So, alright? Now then, you want to come in from... hopefully I can hold this on the camera. You want to come in just from the back edge of your slide apron, which is this, or the guide rod tunnel, as a lot of people know it. You want to come in from the back edge. You want to come in, if I can measure this blooming thing correctly. You want to come in roughly, I don't know if you can see it on there, hopefully you can. You want to come in 5 millimetres. So, from the back edge there, forward, 5 millimetres, and that's where that angled or rounded edge starts. So it's 5 millimetres in from the back edge of your slide apron or guide rod tunnel. So you come in 5 millimetres and that's where you start to draw in your rounded edge, alright? And then you go up 5 millimetres from the underside, alright? Hopefully you'll get the gist of that. So that's sort of your overall dimensions. Now, the reason why you might want to cut these chin cutouts is to, i.e. 4.3 size slides, because these are always designed, for some reason, Tokyo Marine haven't come out with a commander length slide yet, which is what the 4.3 essentially is. So they always go straight to the front, i.e. as if it's an extended dust cover version. Personally, I think it looks stupid on a shortened dust cover to have these extensions on there, but there you go. So Tokyo Marine haven't come out with a commander size length with chin cutouts yet. So, until they do, you've got to try and custom do them yourself. Now, here's one I prepared earlier. As you can see, the chin cutouts are done exactly as they should be if done on a full length slide. So, how do you go about doing it? Right, well, as I say, you transfer those dimensions across that I gave you earlier on, and then you fix your Dremel, which, if you've got one, is one of these. I mean, I'm using a Clark rotary tool system, but I mean, Dremel is a brand name, but anything equivalent to this with a grinding head on the top of it. That's all you really need to begin with. If you can't get hold of one of those, well then you're pretty much stuffed, unless you're really, really good at sanding and grinding or whatever, but by hand. But honestly, you really need a Dremel. That's the only way to go ahead in doing this. Now then, the major bits that you use are these two bits. I don't know the technical names for them, so I'm just going to call one a ball head grinder and the other one a bullet head grinder. The ball head ones are for the bullet cuts that I mentioned earlier on in the book, which are for these ones. So you'd only use that cutter for them, or that grinder I should say, for those, because they're more rounded. If you're going to do the elongated chin cutouts, i.e. the bullet cuts or the longer cuts, then you'd use the bullet head version. Alright? As I say, I don't know the correct technical names for these, but they're the two grinder pieces that I use. You will also need, which is most important of all, a pair of safety goggles. You will need these, believe you me. If ever you use a Dremel, use safety goggles. And gloves if need be, especially if you're using different types of plastic or whatever, because it can affect your skin. Certain plastics are not that best to work with. Also a mask. If you're using this stuff, then fillers and stuff, you can get fine powdery dust come off, and you don't particularly want to be breathing that in. Now then, unfortunately, I haven't actually got one other than this one, which I don't want to cut chin cutouts into because it's off of my Tactical 4.3, or leave that is as it is for the moment. But what you want to do is transfer the dimensions across by using, obviously, a ruler and a pencil. Do your line down to the back edge, or in those dimensions as I mentioned earlier on. Once you've drawn them on, and you've marked them across the front as well, to make sure that they line up both sides. So make sure that your dimensions are identical both sides, because you don't want one chin cut out being higher than it is the other side. So once you've drawn them on, then you get your Dremel. If you can imagine that this one that's currently in the vise here is not cut yet, then let's just put my goggles on. Right, okay. Now then, this might be a bit noisy, so bear with me. But you want to lean on something if you can, so either put a box or something here that you can lean on to stable your hand, so that when you hold it up to the edge of the slide, you can evenly move in to where your markings are, your pencil lines or whatever. Alright? Now I know this one's got filler on, and I've already actually cut the chin cutouts out, but this still has to be ground down because I've used filler on it afterwards to give a nice smooth finish, as per the one there. As you can see, it's a nice smooth edge to it or whatever, which you want as you're finished. But as I say, because I haven't got one that's already been cut, this is exactly the same procedure as you would use to grind in to get the initial cut. All right, it does pay to have a sort of a variable head or headed vise. If you haven't got one, fair enough, it's just how it goes, but to have a variable headed vise, i.e. one that's on a ball mount, does really help. I mean, this one here is, well, hopefully you can see, is a movable headed vise. If this blooming thing will move, there we go. Right, there we go, there's the vise. So as you can see, it's on a ball mounted head, so it's able to move about. So that's what you want, really. If you can't get hold of one of those and you've only got a fixed one like that one there, then fair enough, that's all there is to it, that's all you've got, so you'll just have to go with that. But otherwise, it does pay to have one of these that is movable headed or whatever, is on a ball mount. Right, okay, let's make a start. As I say, this is going to be rather noisy, so bear with me. All you do is you grab your grinder or whatever and move in ever so slightly. Moving in from right to left, or if you're left-handed, from left to right, depends. Just move in, not going too deep, but just ever so gently moving in. Now when you're grinding out for the plastic, you'll have to give a bit more pressure, obviously. But when it's just for taking away the filler, you just want to do it lightly. Alright, as you can see, there's dust coming off. Well, at least I hope you can see. That'll do for that. So we can take our goggles off. Now then, hopefully you'll be able to see what I've done there. As you can see, it's quite smooth now. That's it's gone pretty smooth. Actually, if I take it out. Another thing, by the way, which I have failed to tell you initially, but you will need some packers inside the plastic slide, because otherwise when you go to clamp it up in the vise, it will just press on there and it will bust the slide. So always put packers on the inside. Now then, hopefully you can see, if I zoom that in, there we go. It's quite, I mean, you can't really tell there, but it is getting smoother as we go on it. As I say, if this was just the original plastic in there, all you've got to do is use exactly the same technique, but just with a little more force, keeping to your pencil lines that you've already drawn on there. So as you do one cut, take away the residue, i.e. the bits of melted plastic, take those away, cut them away, whatever. Go in again, grind out a bit more. Again, checking as you go. Always check. Never just go straight in and do the lot in one go. No, check as you go. It may take a while, but at least that way you'll get the exactly correct angle to your chin cut. So there you go. So as I say, that's for cutting, as well as this particular section of the action, which is grinding out for the filler afterwards. All right, as you can see, this filler is sunk, so I'm going to have to put another layer on here afterwards, but I'm not worried about that. This was just to fill in initially and grind out the underside of the chin cut out, so I'm not worried about doing this. This can wait till later on, but this around here is where I wanted the main filler to dry first, so that I could grind this out as is. But as you can see, it's looking fairly good. It's not bad. And eventually it will be like that one, which is nice and smooth. Alright, so hopefully you can pick this out as I'm going. I'll brighten it up a little bit so you might be able to see it a bit better. There we go. So as you can see, this eventually will look like this. Well, hopefully. Now then, coming back to what I was saying earlier on about levelling the two edges up. Now, what I'm on about is your chin cut out either side needs to be identical height either side, because you can't have one chin cut out higher than the other. On my very early Talon 2 pistol, I unfortunately cut one side slightly higher than the other. Never looked right. I always noticed it, although others didn't. So I've since, I'm rebuilding that gun as I speak. So it's being redone with a new slide. In fact, one of these slides is going to be for that particular pistol. So there you go, so that's your chin cutouts, how they will be once they're sprayed and finished. As I say, it's normal spray procedure like you do on your filling in of the markings on the slide. So it's just your filler, a fine filler afterwards to fill any hairline cracks. Once you've done that, a primer coat, two coats of whatever colour you want to put on as your top coat, and then a finish coat of lacquer if you so wish to do so, otherwise you can just leave it black. So there you go, so that's what it will look like when it's finished. This is a commander size slide. This originally was one of these slides, but cut down. So hopefully you can see the length difference if I hold them together and zoom out. There we go. So as you can see, the length difference, not a lot, but it's just a 4.3 and it's just cut down. Fair enough, this is slightly more aggressive angling on there than what it is on the original. That's my own preference. You don't have to do it that like that. You can actually, if you want to, cut down the original slide to get it like that. As you can see, this originally was a 1911 A1 slide, exactly the same as this, so the chin cutouts were already in there, really, but I've just ground them out a little bit more to make a more bullet-type cutout on them. But, I mean, you can do this with the 4.3s, as I say, because that's what we're doing here. That's the 4.3 one. So that will be identical to that. So there you go. So hopefully that explains it a little bit. As I say, the tools you require are a mountable headed or, you know, ball mounted vice, if possible. If you haven't got one and you've only got a G cramp or something like that, then fair enough, just use a G cramp and cramp it to your bench and angle in that way. If you've got a fixed headed vice, fair enough, like this one, then just use that. But the two bits you will need, or grinding pieces you will need, is a ball-ended piece and a bullet-ended piece. They're the two main ones you require. You don't require any others, really, all right, for doing chin cuts. And that's pretty, and obviously your Dremel. And that's pretty much it. So, as I say, it's tricky. You've just got to take your time doing it. As you grind in, say you're coming in at this angle like that, make sure that when you're grinding in for the plastic, to cut the plastic out initially, you clean away the burr edges as you go. Don't leave them and try and do it all in one go, because you'll cover up your pencil lines, you'll forget where they are, and you'll go over them and melt the plastic. So take your time grinding in gently. Try not to cut into the slide apron or guide rod tunnel, because as soon as you burr into that, it means you've got to fill it again. So using your filler, don't particularly want to do that. So just be as gentle as you can. Take your time. Patience, that is the thing. That is the key, is taking your time and being patient. All right, so that's pretty much it on how to do chin cutouts. There is no real hard and fast way of doing it. It's just down to your skills of your hands and patience, and obviously having the correct bits and so forth to do it with. That's pretty much it. If you've got any other queries or whatever, or you're not sure, you know, how did you do that again, whatever, then fair enough, comment below and I'll either get back to you with a PM message or an answer to the comment, or I'll do another video showing it in a bit more detail. But as I say, unfortunately at the moment, I've already ground out all of my 4.3 slides. So it's just literally polishing them up now, as you saw me do on there. But it's exactly the same principle to actually cut out the plastic. It's exactly the same way. You just draw on your pencil line and then just grind it out the same way. All right, so there's no real difference. As I say, it's exactly the same technique. It's just that I'm sanding the filler out on these ones, other than cutting the plastic out. But otherwise, it's exactly the same. Okay, hopefully that's given you pointers into how to do this. As I say, it's tricky, yes, and it's all down to patience, but skill and everything else you build up as time goes on. I made mistakes, as I admitted, on my Talon 2 one. It looked atrocious when I first did them. It didn't look good at all. I've since got better and better as I've gone along, and now I'm coming back to my older pistols and redoing the slides to make them better. Fair enough, some of you out there haven't got funds to pay out for numerous different slides. I quite understand this, so you want to make sure you do it right first off. If that is the case, time, patience, and checking as you go is the way to do it. All right? Take your time. Don't rush it. Do a little bit at a time, and then if you make a mistake, all right, if you've ground out a little bit too much out of the guide rod tunnel, or there's a little bit too much out of there, then fair enough, go back to the filler, fill it, start again, and then just grind out the filler as you go. But as I say, if you take your time, do your measurements correctly, and follow your pencil lines that you've already marked on there, then you shouldn't have any problems. All right? Okay, hopefully that's given you some ideas and some pointers and some help into how to do this. As I say, it's not that hard. It's just time and patience. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. As I always say, stay sharp, but stay safe. This is LaZouche Custom Shop signing off. Bye for now.